But today, we are going to focus on one of the repercussions of what happened. It's a piece of history that actually most people have never heard of, myself included. And it's what happened to the communities, in particular Little Tokyo, after all the people of Japanese ancestry were incarcerated. And apparently, they did not lie dormant. A new community with its own culture rose up, and it's a community called Bronzeville. So we look forward to learning more about that from some people that we'll have in a panel later. And I'm actually looking forward to learning about it along with all of you. But to get started, first we have a musical tribute to the melding of the cultures that took place 75 years ago. And the composer of this piece has been a professional musician for 30 years. He was the composer for the PBS miniseries, Japan, Memoirs of a Secret Empire, and American Fusion, an independent feature. He has also composed scores to many documentaries for the Watase Media Arts Center at the Japanese American National Museum. In the past, he has toured with the Pointer Sisters, Olivia Newton-John, Tom Scott, Paul Anka, Willie Bobo, Alphonse Muzan, John Lucian, Hiroshima, and the Fifth Dimension. Currently, he's touring with Peebo Bryson, Marilyn McCoo, and Billy Davis. He has created a way to combine his passion for music with serving the community. A multiple arts grant recipient, he has created several community-centric projects, including the Healing Drums, designed to illustrate harmony and unity among the communities of Los Angeles. Barbed Wire and Hip Hop, a hip hop CD about the Japanese American concentration camps, and J-Town Bronzeville Suite, a musical exploration that we are about to hear. Obviously, we are blessed to have this very talented individual here with us. It's my honor to introduce to you Dave Iwataki.
Good thing I wrote it, huh? Anyway, I thank you all for being here. It means a lot that you're all here. And I especially want to thank the Gardena JCI for inviting me. This was originally written about 10 years ago, Mia. the fact that they're having this year-long remembrance of the executive order 9066 and inviting me here to present this, I'm real proud, very proud. And so I'm just going to get into it. The suite, J-Town Bronzeville Suite, is in three movements. The first movement is designed to reflect how I imagined Little Tokyo might have been up until 1941, vibrant and bustling with businesses, arts, and culture. The first song in this movement is a Shigin song called Fujisan. Shigin, it's a recitation of Japanese or Chinese poetry, and today it's going to be sung by Patrick Seki, accompanied by Greg Matsuda. And the reason I wanted to have Shigin is because it's really at the root of one of the art forms that's at the root of Japanese culture. And we're lucky that Patrick is still practicing it, presenting it. Also, some of the other music that I wrote for this movement, it's how I imagine summer festivals or Obon might have been. And let's see here, I wrote way too much stuff. So I've written songs that try to capture the style of Japanese traditional music for Koto and Shakuhachi, to represent the community, and especially the Issei, the Japanese immigrant pioneers who were the foundation of our growth. The first movement will close with a taiko improvisation representing catastrophic events that led to the incarceration of the Japanese Americans. So we're going to start the first movement with Patrick Seki and Greg Matsuda. 1945, the incarceration of the Japanese Americans turned all the Japan towns on the West Coast into ghost towns. They then became home to thousands of African American migrant workers from the Deep South. Little Tokyo became known as Bronzeville. And during the Bronzeville period, 42 through 45, little by little, breakfast clubs opened up, provided places for local and visiting jazz luminaries, such as Charlie Parker, Miles Davis, Billie Holiday, Gerald Wilson, many others to play. First they'd play further south on Central Avenue till 2 a.m. and then come to Bronzeville and play till the sun came up and breakfast time. This is Henry Franklin.
Thank you.
Bronzeville Quartet, I call them. You know, that's Louis Van Taylor. John Littleton. We met Henry Franklin. Theo Saunders. Okay, so part three, post-war, J-Town, Bronzeville. 1945, the war ends, and the Japanese Americans return to their homes in Little Tokyo. The African Americans begin to leave the area, and the transition is not always smooth, and there is some discord. The music of the third movement reflects the discord with the first song you'll hear called Dissonance. And then a gradual dialogue between the two communities is represented by what I call fluet. It'll be a duet between the two flutes. With relief and reconciliation with a song called Then One Night. And finally, celebration with a reprise of Shep's Playhouse, which you just heard. So, I'm gonna stay on stage for this one.
Thank you. Thank you.
Henry Franklin, Theo Saunders, and Yuki Yasuda.